It's the largest line shaft turbine and irrigation pump in Central Oregon.
The well is Big Bertha, the pump is Big Bertha, and even on our tax bill, it is known as Big Bertha.
Big Bertha runs 5 pivots, 9 wheel lines, and about 350 hand lines.
We've known that this was a high usage system. We knew it needed some modernization.
In order to run one pivot, they've had to run 4 to 6 pivots to keep the pressure down without blowing things apart.
One night it happened, and so the next morning I didn't have pressure on the other pivots. So I'm driving out along the main line trying to find out what happened, and the front end of my pickup falls in a great big hole. You know, my bumper's on the ground, the tires are in the mud, you know. And so you're losing irrigation, your crop needs water, so your downtime is about a day.
When you have multiple irrigation systems, such as a wheel line and a pivot, the wheel line system may need to run at 55 to 60 PSI versus a drip system, or a low pressure pivot may only need to run at 30 PSI. So we can actually use a variable frequency drive to take advantage of the times when we don't need those high pressures or when there's change in flow.
So once this program was announced, we could see it was relatively low risk for the irrigator. Simple rebate, that's what sold the project.
If somebody was going to shut a pivot down, they had to be up here closing valves and monitoring what the pressure was, or they'd be blowing pipes out of the ground. And now it's got what I call an AB switch on it. It's actually ABCD switch that, depending on what Tom's irrigating and what Grossmans are irrigating, if they're irrigating everything and Tom's running the wheel lines at the far end of his ranch, he has to be running at about 80 PSI. So he comes up and puts it on A. He doesn't even have to get off his four-wheeler, just runs up and switches it to A.
Just by a flip of the switch, I can run it at 50 pounds or 80 pounds. So there's a big savings, because instead of having to run everything at 80 pounds 24/7, I can run it at 50 pounds for 12 hours of that day.
It has made the system work so much better. The VFD saved in the water and the power, but beyond that, it saved in labor, it saved in repairs, it saved in fertilizers that you weren't wasting by overwatering and washing those out. You could operate the business more economically in many ways at the same time as saving your energy and your water.
Instead of running 100%, we're still down like 92 or 94% power draw from normal. But our biggest savings is in the spring and the fall, and we're saving probably about 60 to 70% on the power bill.
We estimated energy savings would result in a simple payback in approximately 2 years. So if you have variables in flow and pressure, variable crops, definitely something to look at. Consider it strongly.
I can sleep at night now. Before, when the pivot shut off at night, I wanted to get up and make sure the main line didn't blow apart or something like that. Now, when the pivot shuts down, the pump drops from 80 pounds of pressure down to whatever we haven't adjusted at.
The VFD has made everybody's life a lot easier. So now if you only need to water the vineyard, you can dial down the system. So only using the power that you need and the water that you need.
It's peace of mind more than anything. Plus, I'm sure we're saving 25% right now.
We look at energy savings as a resource. The more energy savings we can bring in through our programs in agriculture, the less we have to worry about as far as generation.
Saving water and saving energy a lot of times go hand in hand. So one of the first things we try to do is get people just to start with the basics. And the basics, in a lot of cases, is just the sprinkler hardware rebate programs that are available through your local utility.
It's a win for the utilities because they can meet their targets. It's a win for the RC&Ds because it helps them fulfill their purpose. It's a win for the farmers because they can reduce their energy load, their water load, their fertilizer. And it's a win for Bonneville because it helps us meet our targets.
I just encourage you to contact your local utility and see what's available in your area, and then they can put you in touch with the folks that can actually come out to the farm and help run some very basic calculations just to get a rough idea on where you stand and what the opportunities may be and what programs you may qualify for.